Hey everyone, thought I would do an art journal page. I just do like I was doing challenges in this one, and I just feel like doing another page. Gonna use some Mod Podge this time. I don't even know what I'm gonna do except that I'm gonna put a napkin down because I have some pretty napkins, and I thought it would be fun to do a flower one. Like this. So I think what I'm gonna do is just I wonder if I can tear with my tearing tool. Have a Creative Memories tearing tool. I don't know if it works for a napkin. That would be fantastic. Whoops. Not too bad actually. Whoops, sorry for that noise. Not too bad. All right. Anyway, I think I shall use Mod Podge and just do a bunch of Mod Podge stuff. So I know I need to get this napkin separated. There it is. Because when you're going to Mod Podge it, you do need to pull off parts you're not going to use. And I'm pretty much using all of it. Can't say that it did the tearing especially the way I'd like, but I'm going to tear off some more. I feel like it wasn't enough. And actually it goes more like this. Kind of a garden. It's kind of a garden thing. And I'm gonna Mod Podge some stuff in it. And I had a picture somewhere of such a cute little bunny. I think it was in here. Yeah, there it is. That would be so cute down in the bottom. And then a bird up top. I think this bird. So yeah, I'm gonna use those two things as well in this garden. I'm gonna Mod Podge those. Okay. So let me just check, make sure I'm in frame. Yep. So I'm gonna just start by getting a whole bunch of Mod Podge down on my book. This is an old book, 1930s, I think. It's called, the story's called Zest. And I just got it for like a buck. You know, a dollar at a thrift store. So obviously is a good find. So, and I've gotten a lot of my books like that way, just from like thrift stores. Okay. All right. So we want that to just come down here. Let's get the edges. And then I have some other things I'm going to like stick on it, like I said. And I still have a little bit of the song sheet left that I had cut up. So since I'm putting birds on it, I might as well just do this as well, right? I'm just gonna do this while it's all nice and wet because then I can just stick everything down at the same time. And I shouldn't have so much trouble getting it to stay. And we're gonna put the bird right here. Then I'm probably going to add some stamping and stuff to it. Okay. Get those bunnies down, sticking good. And of course, this stuff always dries clear. I put like wax paper between my pictures, because especially when you use something like that, it tends to stick. So you do want to try to prevent that as much as possible. And I think that's all I need. So I am going to turn this off and clean my brush and dry my pages, and then I will come back and we will see how it looks. I'm just getting this spread a little better. I want to make sure that the edges stay down. Okay. I shall return. Okay, it's dry, so I'm going to do one stamp on here. It's a sun. I have some stamps of sun and moons with faces and stuff. And I'm gonna use my Stazon ink. I know this doesn't like stamp as good as I would like. It's fairly worn. I got it at the thrift store, but I really like it. So I'm gonna try and get enough on here to actually get a good stamp. We'll see. I'm gonna put it right here. And it might not even come out that great, but I guess you don't know unless you try. Let me just leave that sit there a second. Get these out of my way. All right. Actually, not horrible, right? Not horrible. Let me, I'm just gonna pull a wipe out of here, and now they've all fallen back. Of course, they've fallen back. Let me see if I can get one. All right. I'm just curious. Nope, can't get that off. But I gotta clean off my little thing here. All right. Let me put my lid back on my wet wipes so that we don't have any issues. And get this threaded through correctly. So next time I pull these out, it's not such a pain. Okay. All right. So that one is done. So then what I was gonna do is write, I'm not gonna write, but I'm gonna put down red stickers, alpha letters, and then I'm gonna do something on them to kind of darken them up a little bit once I'm done. But I wrote an emotions haiku, oh my gosh, sometime last year. I don't remember when. I have poetry. I have a website that I haven't done much on, but I have put all my poetry up on it. So if I remember, I will put that below in the notes so that if you're interested, you can look at it. And the haiku is, we don't always know what squeezes hearts to cause tears from words well spoken. Okay, I did get interrupted there. My husband came home, so I went ahead and put the letters on to my haiku. So we don't always know what squeezes hearts to cause tears from words well spoken. And this is when people say things to us that are really kind and thoughtful and affirming. That, it sometimes causes tears, right? So that's where that haiku came from that I wrote. I'm going to use these just to do a little bit of addition, color to the pages. So I have a really pretty greenish or blue and turquoise or something, and then a green. So I'm just going to take a baby wipe. And I'm just going to blot these pages so that it's not just stark white. I'll probably do the green more down below. But yeah, I like that. I wanted to do an art journal. I'm caught up on the art challenges, the Take Five art challenges that Kyra Pace does. And so I thought, well, I really feel like I've got the time. So before we go pick up my granddaughter to do this, so I thought it would be fun to just go ahead and do a page. So that's what I'm doing. Okay, I'm gonna go with the green now. I don't think the green shows up as well, so I think we'll just stick with that blue, because that seems to show up a lot better. Yeah, that's better. Yeah, so that was a fun project. Just a napkin, magazine cutouts with gesso, and a little bit of sheet music, and then a stamp, and then the words to a haiku. So actually, I like that a lot. We'll see if we can get this just a little darker spots. I kind of like there's a little bit of an effect going on that I like on the edges of the page. I really like it. Yeah. Fun. Okay, so there we go. All done. I had a lot of interruptions, unfortunately, so I'm gonna have to piece my video together. But thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. Bye.